Hey guys, welcome to Road to Riot. I'm Bubby FPV.
I'm Les Flair C.
And today we're talking about the top 5 FPV accessories that you need.
You're not an FPV pilot if you don't have these 5 things.
Yeah. I was just a young little FPV pilot and I showed up to quad camp in for Road to Riot quad camp, and I didn't have a prop tool. I had some pliers and I got made fun of and I was crying after. I felt
you were
so
really
bad.
Kind. Oh my gosh, they were so mean.
I remember it because I was like, I'm sorry, I don't have a prop tool. But
so
yeah.
You used a pair of pliers
I
to
used
put
a
your
pair of pliers.
Props on?
Yes.
Wow, that's pretty bad. The first accessory that you need for FPV is a prop tool.
Prop tool.
Whether it be a socket wrench.
Or a drill.
Yeah, I got a $10 drill from Harbor Freight. It's like at the perfect amount of torque to where it doesn't rip your fingers off. But enough torque to put the prop on and keep it from getting loose.
Yeah.
So while we're on the topic of like props and stuff, I think something else that helps you move your props easier is motor grip.
What's a motor grip?
A motor grip is something that you wrap around the motor to get extra grip to help you take off
the
props. Yeah.
Yeah, like they have the
clamp thingy.
They have the clamps, you know, with the rubber on that. You don't want to use a regular pair of pliers. You will mess the motors up, so don't do that. But we have these little rubber things that we sell in the store where you just wrap it around and you can hold the motor and it keeps you from, you know, hurting your fingers, hurting your hands when you're tightening your props. I've gotten kind of used to just using my hands, but there are some motors, like the little 3-inch motors that are a little too small sometimes, and that little rubber grip really helps.
Yeah, are your hands cut up? Because I know before I used this motor grip, my hands always had cuts going through them.
Well, I think at first, I got kind of used to it. I kind of now kind of just hold the prop with my fingers and hold the motor at the same time. And I got it all figured out as to just how to hold it where I don't cut my hands when I do it. Now, if you're using a really strong drill, like we talked about earlier, that will cut my hands. So our second item on the list was motor grip, in case you missed that. Number 3 on the list of essential accessories is a backpack. Now don't be that guy that shows up to the field. You know that guy that brings the Tupperware container? What is it, 2021 now?
Yeah, I know, right?
You gotta have a backpack. It doesn't have to be an expensive backpack. Now you could go out and you could buy yourself a nice $200 backpack.
Torval, I like that backpack.
I personally like the, I don't even know what I fly. I use the Skypack, because it has a lot of room, tons of crap that can fit in there. Yeah. I put all my stuff in the Skypack. I mean, you've got to find one that has all the little loopy things on it so you can hook all your drones to the outside of it.
You can look cool, like you roll up to the spot and you're like, I got my drone backpack.
Yeah, I mean, you got to let everybody know that you brought your drones with you.
Yes.
You can always get a skateboard backpack because skateboard backpacks, they have straps on the back to hold your skateboard, but you can use them for your drone. And then you look like you got a legit backpack, but you got the cheap Etnies backpack.
That's never what I started with.
I got the skateboard backpack. I strapped the drone. Looks the part. I didn't have to pay for it.
I started off with a jewelry box.
Really? You started off with a jewelry box?
Before I flew drones, I'd show up to the airplane, RC plane field, and I would have my little jewelry box that my mom gave to me, and I'd open it up, and it'd be all pretty, and I'd...
Where'd you get a jewelry? Your mom?
My mom,
mom's jewelry box. Wow.
Yeah. It was
funny.
Huge, though, but...
Oh, my gosh.
I was definitely
I guess it's for all your little bits and pieces. You probably didn't put your drone in the jewelry box.
I mean, I did planes at the time, so it just held like, radios
all the
and
things
stuff.
For the planes, yeah.
But it didn't look cool. It didn't look cool at all. Number 4, antennas.
Well, you gotta have antennas.
Yeah, you gotta have antennas.
You can't fly without an antenna, right? I like the patch antennas. My favorite antenna to have on my goggles, you technically need antennas for your goggles and your quad, right? So my favorite antenna to fly with my goggles is just dual patches. I'm patch all the way. I think they're crosshairs. They're actually crosshairs technically, not patches, but.
I'm omnis all the way, man.
Like, really?
Omnis all the way, because I can stand in the middle of the fly field and just fly all around myself. With your patches, you can only go in front of you.
Let me tell you something. I just recently took a trip to Detroit, and I flew in buildings that are bigger than anything we have in Florida. They've got more concrete and metal than you could ever imagine. And with my dual patches and my DJI setup, I could fly behind myself to the end of the bando, all the way in front of myself to the other end of the bando, all sides. I mean, not to be a DJI shill or anything, but with the DJI setup, my patches, I can fly behind myself with no problem. It doesn't bother me at all. Yeah. You should try it.
I gotta try it. I can penetrate
like nobody's business. Everywhere we go, Drew flies with omnis, I fly with patches, and I get farther than he does every time.
Nice. Well.
All right, so number 5 is technically on the list, but I don't necessarily agree that it needs to be there. I don't actually use a radio lanyard.
I mean, you need one. Dude, remember when you, blah, you just threw the radio, blah,
remember that? Okay, I like to throw my radio on the ground. No, seriously though, I had to fight myself on this because I originally started out with a radio lanyard. I see Schizo with his, and Drew likes to fly that Schizo with his, yeah, with his radio way up here, with a little tiny lanyard. Some people like it way down
here. I'm down here, I'm like, yeah.
Originally started out with a lanyard because I flew airplanes, and if I didn't have the lanyard on my radio, I would literally drop the radio. Fly somebody else's quad, they'd bring over their radio and hand to me, and I would say, oh, you got a lanyard? You don't have a lanyard? I can't fly without a lanyard. So I had to break that habit. I felt like I needed to break that habit because I didn't want to fly somebody else's quad or fly somebody else's plane and just drop the radio when I was done with it, just out of habit because I'm used to letting go.
Yeah, okay, I guess that makes sense, but like, I kind of hold the radio too, but I like to have it as a backup, because I know if I'm going through a crazy dive and then there's a pull in the middle of the way, I'm gonna go like this, and okay. My radio's gonna go flying, and it's just nice to.
So you need a crutch.
I need a crutch.
Basically, you need a crutch.
I need a crutch.
All right. Well, you fly pretty good, so I mean,
it's fine,
I'll let you have your crutch. It's okay. All right, guys. So that's the 5 FPV accessories that you need to fly FPV.
Wait, we're forgetting something.
What?
T-shirts. Rotorite t-shirts.
You gotta have your Rotorite t-shirt, right? Or if you're not a real FPV pilot, if you don't have a Rotorite t-shirt.
That's facts right there, guys. If you wanna get a t-shirt, you can go to Rotorite.com.
Don't forget the
If there's an accessory that you can't live without that we missed, make sure you leave a comment and let us know. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell.
See you next time on Rotorite.
Bubby, no pressure.
Wait for it to start counting. You'll see it through this.
We're doing it right now.
See?
It's counting.
This episode needs to be ready for Monday.
Put that in your pocket.
Don't touch it. You got 2 days. Okay? Because we forgot to make an episode. Okay? It all comes down to you. Don't mess up. Sit and clap.